the early years of 29, he was able to walk away from corporate America, replacing his and his wife's two six-figure income. Okay, and now he has two massive houses, one in Chicago and another in Atlanta, and beautiful lifestyle. But I'm not going to talk about his lifestyle or anything about that. But what I'm going to share with you tonight is my learnings from my business mentor, and hopefully few things which I share with you tonight will impact you and your thought process, and tonight you go back and start to think a bit differently about your life and your perspective of life. And if the things make sense, the business project plan, I'll be sharing a business concept with you, if that makes sense. Whoever has invited you tonight, you know, please get back to that person to get some more information about the business project plan. If it doesn't make sense to you as well, that's also okay, as long as you know, I get you to think a bit about your own sort of finances and where you are heading. And if you do not change anything, you know, or your thought process, if you don't change anything, where you end up, that is what my objective of tonight is, to get you to think. Okay, great. So anyone here who is for the first time, you have been invited, you are in this room for the first time, you have never been here before, you have quite a few people. Okay, great. So what I'm going to share with you is hopefully, okay, we have some papers. Okay, so it's, as I said, you know, you start to think. Okay, so now we're talking about money. Okay, it's not evil. Yeah, money is not evil. Or anyone thinks money is evil? Yeah?
No, you people are very serious here. What is this guy is talking about? I was also sitting like, you know, some of you guys, hands crossed.
Anyways, so what I'm going to share with you tonight is you know, a book which I read, and I will encourage you to read this book. If not anything tonight makes sense to you, you go back and read this book called Cash Flow Quadrant, written by a guy called Robert Kiyosaki. His New York Times best-selling book was Rich Dad Poor Dad. It became the New York Times bestseller for, I think, around 7 to 8 consecutive years. Okay, so one of the best books of financial education or entrepreneurship. Okay, so read that book. But this is not my concept. This is this gentleman Robert Kiyosaki's concept. And as a matter of fact, him and the current U.S. president, Donald Trump, they co-authored another book called Why We Want You to Be Rich. That's also one of the famous book, so you can read that book as well. But what he's talking about in this book is about four different ways people make money in this world. Okay, he talks about employment. Okay, employees. So that means you work for a company, you are an employee of that company. Okay, you can be self-employed. Okay, so that means usually you work for a company, especially my background is IT. So after I worked in IT for a few years, then I started to contract. So better pay, you know. So you're not even your own boss, but you know, you kind of quadruple or, you know, your income goes substantially high. You know, you become self-employed person. If you are not in IT, you know, you are a doctor, you open your own sort of clinic or a GP practice, then you are self-employed person. Okay. So it talks about employees and self-employed people. They work, okay, here they work in a job, okay, and here they kind of work for themselves, but that means they own this job, okay. So they work in somebody else's job, but this is they own this job, okay, so they have to deliver that. Now it talks about another two, so it talks about left quadrant and right quadrant. Very, very important this concept is, it talks about these people who are on the right side, they are the businessmen, okay? Businessmen and investors, okay? Most of the people, if you see, all the rich people in this world, they are either, you know, they own their own businesses, or they made their own lot of money, and they start to invest or let money work for them. So that's investors, okay? So the gradual progression usually should, as per that book, is should be like this: employees and self-employed. Then you start your own business, and then whatever money you make, you start to invest. Okay. Now, four different ways people make money in this world, but the statistics says, or if you would also know, that 90% people are in this side. Okay. So majority of the people are on the left side and only 10% are in the right side. What does that mean? So that in population wise, majority of the people, they work for these 10% people. Okay. So in this room, if you take a statistics, you know, you would be here tonight if you are already, you know, in this side. Okay, so that means you are either employee or you are a self-employed person. Okay. Now, nothing wrong with that, 90%, but the wealth-wise, these 90% people, they have only 10% of the wealth, and these 10%, they have 90% of the wealth. That is really sad. I was reading somewhere, I think, you know, last week. Only, I think, eight people, okay, starting from, you know, Jeff Bezos, the Amazon CEO, then Bill Gates, he has become now, Microsoft has become a $1 trillion company now, following Amazon. And then, you know, the seven, like, you know, the founder of Google, and what's his name? So, seven people, okay, their total wealth is higher than, you know, the African subcontinent, you know, entire sort of, you know, wealth of the African subcontinent is much higher than, or double than that, something like that. So, huge statistics is, you know, amazing. But anyways, if you see these people, they have a lot of wealth, okay, and these people, very little. Now, if you see, they call it, these people are, they create income, they create wealth. Now, when my business partner shared this concept, I never heard about this sort of thing like income and wealth. My parents taught me that, son, get a good education, get a good job, you are set for life.